pre-hug? What if we don't do a good job?
Do you take it back?
So I have some little notes here. I've written a little bit. I don't know if anybody's familiar with MissMinimalist.com. And so I wrote a kind of a, she does this real life minimalist thing, which I posted, but it turns out that everybody gets posted. It's just a first come, first serve kind of thing. So, yay. But, I was excited. So I grew up kind of in a perpetually cluttered home, you know, not hoarders, but just a lot of stuff there. When you're a kid, you don't really feel like you have the authority to actually do anything about that environment. You know, you're just like, well, I guess this is just how it is. I mean, and then you would try to get rid of something, and mom would be like, you're not getting rid of that, you know, kind of thing. My dad repaired furniture and restored antiques and things like that, and a lot of times, like, people would never come and get it, and so now we've got a new table, and now we've got another chair, and, like, we still have this fight with these chairs, and, like, I joke with them that literally we could see, like, 80 people in our living room, you know, like, this is a little over the top. And so I had kind of gotten on board with, like, you know, trying to slowly, okay, I'm an adult now, like, I can start slowly getting rid of some things, and the real kicker for me came from my friend Molly and I decided we were gonna run a marathon. She was a runner, I'm not really a runner, I did it, and I haven't really done it since then, but anyway, so we went to Portland to run this marathon, have a little vacation, and Portland is like a really cool place to shop. There is, you know, there's thrift stores and like there's these farmers markets and just all kinds. And we were just like buzzing. Powell books, you know, like we've been in there and like we're buying books and like all these fun things. And it was just like, we came out of there like, okay, we need to calm down a little bit. So after that, I think is when I really went home. I think that was about 2 years ago. And I was like, because before I was like, okay, I'm not going to buy as much, but if it's really cool, then I'm going to buy it, you know. But there's a lot of things that are really cool. So then I went home, and I really was like, that kind of left my head spinning. And that's when I started to really start getting rid of things. And I realized I probably had a table full of, like, gifts that people had given me and, you know, things like that, that I finally started... you know, started to be like, okay, it's okay. You can get rid of this. People are not going to feel bad. People are, you know, not going to be hurt. It's hard though, living in the society that we're in. You know, it's to get people to stop giving you gifts. You know, and I am to the point now where I'm just like, I kind of cringe. I'm just like, oh, thank you. You know, and then I guess you can be, you know, you can have gratitude, and then and they will never know that you just brought it to Goodwill or, you know, you did something with it. So I'm learning. I'm getting there. And I think I shared before that the hard part for me is kind of moving beyond, you know, the physical decluttering, I guess, and then learning like, well, you're taking all this stuff away. But what are you going to add that with? What are you going to add to your life that's going to enrich it if you're going to take all these distractions away?